Florida is what we call a no-fault state, meaning we have attached to your automobile policy, you have a type of coverage. Every policy in Florida has a type of coverage called PIP, personal injury protection, also called no-fault. Whenever you get medical treatment following a crash, your no-fault insurance on your own insurance policy is the primary insurance. So if you have a Blue Cross or an Aetna or United Healthcare or some other private health insurance, TRICARE, Medicare, Medicaid, those are secondary payers. Your PIP is your primary payer, and so they're going to be the first ones to pay the bill. Well, PIP doesn't pay 100% of the bill. PIP pays 80% of the bill. The other 20% is your responsibility. And so maybe that's covered by your insurance, maybe it's not. Maybe you don't have health insurance. And if that's the case, then you're going to get 80% of your bill paid, but that other 20% is going to come out of your pocket until you get recovery from the other side. Now, the way the law in Florida is a hospital, most providers have to submit their bill to PIP within 30 days of treatment being rendered. Hospitals are given a little bit more time. So what happens if you get a call from the insurance company and they say, hey, look, you're in a wreck, we want to try to make things right, we'll give you $1,500, we'll give you $1,000, $2,000, $5,000, and you sign that paper. Well, then, while you're signing that paper, your PIP benefits are being processed, and if you went to one of the local hospitals and you had any type of diagnostic test done, like a CT scan, one or two CT scans, your PIP is gone.
Yep.
You know, that $10,000 will get you into the ER, it'll get you one CT, it'll get you seen by the doctor, it'll get the radiologist paid 80%, and then your PIP benefits are gone. And so you're left with this massive amount of bills that aren't being covered, or the 20% is still obviously out there, and that $2,000 or $3,000 that you settled for 2 or 3 weeks earlier isn't anywhere close to being sufficient enough to pay that out-of-pocket expense. And that's really the sad part. Mm-hmm. I mean, and you know, it was a couple years ago, I remember we had one, it was Christmas time. They wanted to get some money because they wanted to use the money. And they said, well, you know, I think we're gonna be okay. And it was like $1,500, $2,000. And then come January, they get a bill from the hospital and it was more than double. Their out-of-pocket portion was more than double what they had agreed to settle for, and you look at it and you go, I'm sorry.
Right.
There's nothing we really can do. So before you sign anything, please contact an attorney.